Skate the Infinity Explained. 5 facts about Skate the Infinity. I'll be going over some background information, history, facts, and the premise or introduction to the series. So I will mention some things only from the trailers and the first episode. Anyway, let's get straight into it. Fact number 1. SK8 or Skate the Infinity is an anime original, which means that it is not based on any comic or manga source material. It's a Japanese television series that is animated and produced by Studio Bones. Studio Bones is the same studio that produced many other big and awesome anime titles like Fullmetal Alchemist, My Hero Academia, Soul Eater, and Mob Psycho 100. So Bones is definitely a top tier studio, so you can expect good animation and it's also very appealing with vibrant colours. Skate the Infinity anime series started on the 9th or 10th January 2021, and it is set for only 12 episodes. They mentioned it being on ABC TV and TV Asahi's Animazing programming block. It is also licensed by Aniplex of America and can be watched on Funimation. It is a sports and action anime, but it's not your usual sports anime, since it's actually about skateboarding, which is rare to see in anime, and hard to find an anime on this specific sport. I think it actually is the first ever skateboarding anime that has its main focus on skateboarding. I haven't heard of any others before this. I even asked on the anime subreddit and it seems it actually is the first ever skateboarding anime. Ege is the only other older anime that comes to my mind. Ege is not a skateboarding anime, but it is about inline skating or roller skating, but it's probably the closest thing to a skateboarding anime. We also have some other skating anime that don't really focus on skateboarding, but just other general forms of skating like ice skating or figure skating, such as Yuri on Ice. Other than that, we do see skateboards being used in some other anime series, but it's not the main focus at all, like Killua from Hunter x Hunter riding a skateboard. So yeah, Skate the Infinity anime is definitely a big and new thing for us. Fact number 2. Skate the Infinity anime is directed by Hiroko Utsumi, and she is involved in the main story. Hiroko Utsumi is also known for being the series director for 2 other anime. She directed another sports anime called Free, which is an anime about swimming that came out in 2013. The other series she is known for directing is a 2018 action anime called Banana Fish, so she is definitely experienced as a director. Another person who is heavily involved in the series is Ichiro Okuchi. Ichiro Okuchi actually took part in composing the story and script of Code Geass, which is another anime original series, a 2006 anime, and in my opinion one of the best anime of all time, definitely in my top 10. So you can expect Skate the Infinity to be another awesome anime original series. So yeah, Skate the Infinity anime is definitely in very good hands. I mean, it has already inspired a spin-off manga which was just recently announced and it is in the works. The spin-off manga is called Skate Chill Out. It will launch on Kadokawa's Young Aesop manga website. The person in charge of drawing the manga is Toriyasu. The manga will focus on the friendships among the skaters and showcase even more awesome skateboard races. Fact number 3. The main character's name is Reki Kyan. Reki is a very cheerful and energetic high school student who absolutely loves skateboarding. He is obsessed with it. Reki's character design is awesome and reminds me of Mori Jin from the God of High School webtoon and anime series. Anyway, Reki gets caught up in S. What is S? Well, S is a highly secret, hidden and dangerous skateboarding race. The average person doesn't even know that such a thing exists. The average person can't go there and take part. You need the S sticker thingy, like the one Reki gets from someone in a low-key manner, like he's trying to get some illegal drugs or something. It's expected for someone obsessed with skateboarding like Reki to be aware of something like S. S takes place in an abandoned mine. They say only the chosen ones get to take part in this special race. You have to skate down from the top of the hill all the way down to the abandoned factory at the bottom. Whoever gets to the goal first wins. But it's more than just a normal race, since you can pretty much do anything. You can even attack or interfere with your opponents. Basically, it's a youth skateboard race battle, so pretty much anything goes. Things can get really crazy and serious. So there is a lot of action, and it also has some nice funny scenes. Just imagine the Fast and Furious movies with their awesome street racing, but just replace the cars with skateboards. And also the skateboarding is very well choreographed, so you can actually appreciate the race and the outcome of the youth skateboard race battles. Fact number 4. The second main character's name is Langa Hasegawa and he is 17 years old. Langa is a transfer student. He came from Canada and joined the same school as Reki and he becomes good friends with him. Even though Langa came from Canada, his mum is actually Japanese, so that makes him half Japanese and someone who has come back to Japan. Unlike Reki, Langa doesn't have any experience skateboarding, but it's obvious he will learn to be good at it. Reki actually asks him if he wants to skate. When Langa tries, he fails and trips over straight away and even says that the skateboard is not made for standing on, which I found really funny. The reason he says that is because he has a history in snowboarding, so even though he doesn't know skateboarding, he's still experienced in snowboarding. He just needs to learn to apply his snowboarding skills to skateboarding somehow. If you want, I can cover a lot more about him in another video, so let me know if you want that and even a video about Reki. Anyway, the story goes on with Reki and Langa as they both enter the special S race. Reki has been here before and had a race with another character named Shadow before. Reki actually lost in his earlier race with him. He lost because Shadow attacked him with some sort of bombs and threw Reki off and injured his arm. This time, Reki is here with Langa, this being Langa's first time here. They didn't come here to race. They just came here to just deliver a skateboard, but they get thrown into an unfavorable and tough situation. Reki is still injured, and one of them will have to face up against Shadow. Fact number 5. There are also other very awesome characters and skateboarders that we see in the trailers and in the opening. I'll just go over them all again very briefly and even go over some of my thoughts and speculations. We have the main character Reki, the high school student who's obsessed with skating. He is voiced by Tatsuku Hatanaka, so he has the same voice actor as Denki Kaminari from My Hero Academia. Then we have Langa, the transfer student from Canada. He is voiced by Chiaki Kobayashi, so he has the same voice actor as young Askelad from Vinland Saga. Then we have Shadow, the anti-hero of the S-Races. He is voiced by Kenta Miyake, so he has the same voice actor as All Might from My Hero Academia. Imagine that, the number one hero voicing the anti-hero. He's also the same voice actor as Scar from Fullmetal Alchemist and Rack Rayfraser from the Tower of God anime. Then we have Cherry Blossom, the super intelligent AI skater. We see him be given a lot of money for something, most likely for his technology or AI stuff. He is voiced by Hikaru Midorikawa, so he has the same voice actor as Garo from One Punch Man, as well as Android 16 and Tien from DBZ, and also Best Genius from My Hero Academia. Then we have Joe, the fastest six-pack skater. We see him with women, so it seems like he likes to go after them. He is voiced by Yasunori Matsumoto, so he has the same voice actor as Gene Havoc from Fullmetal Alchemist. Then we have Miya, aka the cute catboy, the elite middle school student and candidate for Japan's national team. It seems like he's the guy who wants to get into a good school. He is voiced by Takuma Nagatsuka, so he has the same voice actor as Koji Koda from My Hero Academia, and also Gigwim from the God of High School anime. Then we have Tadashi Kikuchi, the politician's secretary. If he is the politician's secretary, it makes you wonder, who is the politician? This guy seems like he is doing some dealings or shady stuff for someone, most likely for the politician. He was most likely the guy who gave all that money to Cherry Blossom. He is voiced by Kenshiro Ono, so he has the same voice actor as Shikadai Nara from Boruto, Jono Giovanna from Jojo, and also Tetsuya Kuroko from Kuroko no Basuke. And finally, we have Adam, the Matador of Love. We see him near the end of episode 1, watching the S-Races from afar. Seems like he's the real boss guy in this anime. I think he's most likely the politician, and the main bigger plot of the series might be surrounding him. I wonder what his motives are. He must be planning something. He is voiced by Takehito Koyasu, so he has the same voice actor as Aokiji from One Piece, Zeke Jaeger from Attack on Titan, and Bio Brando from Jojo. And that's about all the characters that he introduces in the trailers and the opening. Who do you guys think is the politician? I think it's most likely Adam. The other two possible candidates are Cherry Blossom, or the redhead lady from the opening. She could just be someone else who has some involvement with or against the politician. Anyway, let me know if you guys want to see me do any other Skate the Infinity videos or a similar video like this for any other ongoing anime. And let me know if you are watching and enjoying Skate the Infinity. This is Anime Talks 101, so let's talk about it. Comment down below, I want to know your thoughts.